Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the topic gas power cycle. And this is lecture number 12 in the gas power cycle. And the topic for today's discussion is problems in gas turbine cycle. So we are going to solve few problems from the Anna University question paper in the gas turbine cycle or Brayton cycle. The earlier lecture number 5, we studied about the theory of the gas turbine cycle. So before you listen to this video, you be thorough on the theory. So better listen to the lecture theory part of the gas turbine cycle in the earlier lecture, then you listen to this problem solving problem in this video, so which will be very easy for you to understand. And the learning outcome for this lecture, so at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the gas turbine cycle. This is coming under Bloom's level 3, which is applying. So applying the basic principle, basic equation, what we studied in theory, that we are going to apply for numerical examples. The first example from November 2010 and November 2012 question paper. Air enters the compressor of a gas turbine plant operating on Brayton cycle at 101.325 kilopascal and 27 degrees Celsius. The pressure ratio in the cycle is 6. Calculate the maximum temperature in the cycle and cycle efficiency. Assume WT equal to 2.5 times of WC. So WT is the turbine work, WC is the compressor work, and we take gamma equal to 1.4 for air. So after reading the problem, we write down the given data. So P1 equal to 101.325 kilopascal, T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, and RP pressure ratio equal to 6, and WT equal to 2.5 times of WC, gamma equal to 1.4. And this is the PV diagram for the simple Brayton cycle. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion, and 4 to 1 constant pressure heat rejection. For isentropic compression process, we calculate the temperature after the compression. So T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T1 into RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substituting numerical values, 300 into 6 to the power 1.4 divided by 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 500.5 Kelvin. Then we calculate the maximum temperature. So using the condition WT equal to 2.5 times of WC, we substitute for per unit mass. So Cp into T3 minus T4 is the turbine work equal to 2.5 into Cp into T2 minus T1 is the compressor work. Now Cp is getting cancelled. So T3 minus T4 equal to 2.5 into T2 minus T1. So you take T3 outside from the left hand side. So T3 into 1 minus T4 by T3. Which is equal to 2.5 into T1 minus T2 minus T1. Now the T4 by T3, the ratio T4 by T3 for the expansion process. So P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, because P4 equal to P1, P3 equal to P2. And we know P1 by P2, P2 by P1 is the RP pressure ratio. Now here it is P1 by P2. This is 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So T3 into 1 by RP. So from here T3 into 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma equal to 2.5. T2 equal to 500.5 minus 300. So T3 into substitute numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 501.25. And T3 into 0.4. So calculating the value within the bracket. So the 0.4 equal to 501.25 Kelvin. So which is temperature equal to 1253.1 Kelvin. So the maximum temperature in the cycle is 1253.1 Kelvin. And we calculate the efficiency of the Brayton cycle. Eta B equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1 minus 1 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1. Divided by 1.4 equal to 0.4, which is 40%. So the answer to the problem, the maximum temperature of the cycle is 1253.1 Kelvin and the cycle efficiency is 40%. We take the second problem from November 2013 question paper. Air enters the compressor of a gas turbine at 100 kilopascal and 25 degrees Celsius. For a pressure ratio of 5 and the maximum temperature of 850 degrees Celsius, determine the thermal efficiency using the Brayton cycle. And we have to calculate only the thermal efficiency. So, we write down the given data. So, P1 equal to 100 kilopascal, T1 equal to 25 degrees Celsius. And the pressure ratio equal to 5, T3 maximum temperature is 850 degrees Celsius. So, we have to calculate only the thermal efficiency. So, the efficiency of thermal Brayton cycle, eta B equal to 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1 minus 1 by 5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 0.3686, which is 36.86%. So, the answer to the problem, cycle efficiency is 36.86%. The next question, example 3, it was asked 3 times, May 2013, November 2014 and May 2019. A gas turbine works on air standard Brayton cycle. The initial condition of the air is 25 degrees Celsius and the pressure is 1 bar. The maximum pressure and temperature are limited to 3 bar and 650 degrees Celsius. Determine cycle efficiency, heat supplied and rejected per kg of air, work output, exhaust gas temperature. So, we write down the given data. So, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 25 degrees Celsius, which is 298 Kelvin, P2 equal to 3 bar and T3 equal to 650 degrees Celsius, which is 923 Kelvin. Now, we calculate the pressure ratio, RP equal to P2 by P1, which is 3 divided by 1 equal to 3. And we take the help of pressure volume diagram of the Brayton cycle. So, 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant pressure heat addition, 3 to 4 isentropic expansion and 4 to 1 constant pressure heat removal. And for isentropic compression process, we calculate the temperature after the compression. So, T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T1 into RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So, 298 into 3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 407.9 Kelvin. Then we calculate the isentropic expansion process. We calculate the temperature after expansion, that is the exhaust gas temperature. So, T4 equal to T3 into P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T3 into P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. We know T3 into P1 by P2 equal to 1 by RP. So, 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is substituting numerical values 923 into 1 divided by 3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 674.3 Kelvin. So, the exhaust gas temperature is 674.3 Kelvin and we calculate the heat supplied QS equal to Cp into T3 minus T2, which is 1.005 into 923 minus 407.9 equal to 517.8 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat rejected equal to Cp into T4 minus T1 in constant pressure process. So, 1.005 into 674.3 minus 298 equal to 378.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And the work done equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. So, 517.8 minus 378.2 equal to 139.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And the cycle efficiency, Brayton cycle efficiency is 1 minus 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 0.269, which is 26.9%. So, the answer to the problem, cycle efficiency is 26.9%, heat supplied per kg of air 517.8 kilojoules per kilogram, heat rejected per kg of air 378.2 kilojoules per kilogram, work output 139.6 kilojoules per kilogram and the exhaust gas temperature T4 equal to 674.3 Kelvin. We take example number 4 from November 2018 question paper. A gas turbine works on air standard Brayton cycle. The initial condition of air are 25 degrees Celsius and 1 bar. The maximum pressure and temperature of the cycle are 8 bar and 650 degrees Celsius. Determine cycle efficiency, heat supplied, the heat rejected per kg of air, work output per kg of air and the exhaust gas temperature. So, this problem is very much similar to the previous problem excepting the pressure P2 P3, it was 3, now here it is 8. And we write down the given data. So P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 25 degrees Celsius, it is 298 Kelvin, P2 equal to 8 bar here, and the T3 equal to 650 degrees Celsius, which is 923 Kelvin, and the pressure ratio P2 by P1 equal to 8 by 1 equal to 8, and we calculate the temperature at the end of the isentropic compression process. So T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So we know P2 by P1 equal to Rp. So T1 into Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substitute numerical values 298 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 539.8 Kelvin. And with the help of the PV diagram here for the Brayton cycle, we calculate the isentropic expansion process, the temperature at the end of the isentropic expansion process, or the exhaust gas temperature. So T4 equal to T3 into P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T3 into P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. We know P1 by P2 equal to 1 by Rp. So T3 into 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substitute numerical values 923 into 1 by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 509.5 Kelvin. So the exhaust gas temperature here, it is 509.5 Kelvin. And the heat supplied, QS equal to Cp into T3 minus T2, which is 1.005 into 923 minus 539.8 equal to 385.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And heat rejected equal to Cp into T4 minus T1, which is 1.005 into 509.8 minus 298 equal to 212.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the work done, QS minus QR, net work done equal to heat supplied minus heat rejected. So 385.1 minus 212.5 equal to 172.6 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the efficiency of the Brayton cycle. So from the definition, 1 minus E 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, substituting numerical values 1 minus 1 by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 0.448. So the efficiency is 44.8%. So the answer to the problem, cycle efficiency is 44.8%, heat supplied per kg of air 385.1 kilojoules per kilogram, and the heat rejected per kg of air 212.5 kilojoules per kilogram, work output is 172.6 kilojoules per kilogram, and the exhaust gas temperature is 509.5 Kelvin. We take the next example. Air enters the compressor of a Brayton cycle at 100 Kelvin, 100 kilopascal and 300 Kelvin, with a volumetric flow rate of 5 meter cube per second. The compressor pressure ratio is 10. The turbine inlet temperature is 1400 Kelvin. Determine thermal efficiency of the cycle. So this is from November 2013 question paper. And here again we have to calculate only the thermal efficiency. So pressure P1 equal to 100 kilopascal, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, Rp equal to 10, volume flow rate is 5 meter cube per second, and temperature T3 equal to 1400 Kelvin. So the efficiency of the Brayton cycle, eta B equal to 1 minus 1 by Rp to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Substitute numerical values 1 minus 1 by 10 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 0.482, which is 48.2%. So the answer to the problem, efficiency of the Brayton cycle is 48.2%. So, we take the next example, example number 6 from May 2019 question paper. Air is used as a working fluid in a simple ideal Brayton cycle that has a pressure ratio of 12. The compressor inlet temperature is 300 Kelvin and turbine temperature is 1000 Kelvin. Determine the required mass flow rate of air for a net to power output of 70 megawatt. Assuming both the compressor and the turbine have the isentropic efficiency of 85%. Write down the given data, Rp equal to 12, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1000 Kelvin, the power produced by the turbine plant is 70 megawatts, turbine efficiency, compressor efficiency are equal to 0.85. And this is the temperature entropy diagram for the Brayton cycle with turbine and compressor efficiency. So 1 to 2S isentropic compression, 1 to 2A actual compression. And two, the heat added from 2A to 3, constant pressure heat addition. Then 3 to 4S isentropic expansion in the turbine, 3 to 4A is the actual expansion in the turbine, and the heat is rejected from 4A to 1. So the turbine efficiency and compressor, turbine and compressor efficiency are used to calculate the actual temperature at the outlet of the compressor and actual temperature at the outlet of the turbine. Now we will see how to solve the problem. So for isentropic compression process, we calculate the temperature. So T to S. So 1 to 2S is the isentropic process. So this equation is applicable only for the isentropic process. So T to S equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T1 into RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substituting numerical values, 300 into 12 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 610.2 Kelvin. Then the definition of the compressor efficiency. So compressor efficiency is isentropic work divided by the actual work. So in terms of temperature, T2S minus T1 divided by T2A minus T1. So from this equation, the actual temperature at the outlet of the compressor T2A equal to T1 plus T2S minus T1 divided by the compressor efficiency. So substituting numerical values, 300 plus 610.2 minus 300 divided by 0.85 equal to 664.9 Kelvin. So the actual temperature at the outlet of the compressor is 664.9 Kelvin. And for isentropic expansion process, we calculate T4S. So T4S equal to T3 into P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T3 into P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is equal to T3 into 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this part is very much known to us. Now we substitute numerical values. 1000 into 1 by 12 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4. So calculating this value, this is 491.6 Kelvin. Now we define the turbine efficiency. So turbine efficiency is actual work output of the turbine divided by the isentropic work. So in terms of temperature, T3 minus T4A divided by T3 minus T4S. So from here, T4A equal to T3 minus eta T, turbine efficiency, into T3 minus T4S. So 1000 minus 0.85 into 1000 minus 491.6 equal to 567.86 Kelvin. Now we calculate the work output. So net work output equal to turbine work minus compressor work. So Cp into T3 minus T4A minus Cp into T2A minus T1. So substituting all the numerical values. So 1.005 into 1000 minus 567.86 minus 1.005 into 664.9 minus 300 equal to 67.6 kilojoules per kilogram, and the mass flow rate equal to power divided by the work done. So power equal to 70 megawatts, which is 70,000 kilowatts divided by 67.6 equal to 1035 kilograms per second or 0.29 kilograms per hour. So the mass of the air required, 0.29 kilograms per hour. So the answer to the problem is mass flow rate of air is 0.29 kilograms per hour. And the example number 7 from May 2009 question paper. So in a gas turbine installation, air is supplied at 1 bar and 27 degrees Celsius into a compressor having compression ratio of 8. The air is leaving the combustion chamber heated up to 1100 Kelvin and expanded to 1 bar. The heat exchanger having effectiveness of 0.8 is fitted in the, at the exit of the turbine for heating the air before its inlet into the combustion chamber. Assuming polytropic efficiency of the compressor and the turbine as 0.85 and 0.9, determine the cycle efficiency, work ratio, specific power output of specific work output of the plant. You take Cp equal to 1.0032 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So we write down the given data. P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, pressure ratio equal to 8, temperature T3 at the entry of the turbine 1100 Kelvin, effectiveness of heat exchanger epsilon equal to 0.8, turbine efficiency is 90%, compressor efficiency is 85%, 0.85, Cp specific equal to 1.0032 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And for isentropic compression process, we calculate the temperature at the outlet of the compression. So the T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T1 into RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 300 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 543.4 Kelvin. So the temperature at the outlet of isentropic compression is 543.4 Kelvin. Then we refer to the gas turbine cycle with the regenerator. So we have a compressor turbine coupled together in a same shaft. So we have a combustion chamber. So before the combustion chamber, we have a regenerator. So the air from atmosphere is drawn here. It is getting compressed and leaves with the condition 2. Then it goes to the regenerator where the air is heated to a higher temperature using the exhaust gases. So the turbine exhaust gas has circulated through the regenerator. So here it absorbs the heat energy. Then the hot air with the condition 5, it enters the combustion chamber where it is heated. So fuel is injected and the burning is taking place. Heat is produced and the air is further heated and gas is produced. The gas with the higher temperature enters the turbine, expanded here in the turbine, and it flows through the regenerator and leaves with the condition 6. Now here we have the 5 is the regenerator. So 5 is the inlet of the regenerator, inlet of the combustion chamber. So here the advantage is the exhaust gases, the waste gas from the exhaust gases are utilized for heating the incoming air, and we have to consider the efficiency of the compressor and the efficiency of the turbine here. Now we calculate the efficiency, we define the efficiency of the compressor. So as we told already, WS divided by WA, isentropic work by actual work. Now we define T2 minus T1. So with reference to the temperature entropy diagram, T2 minus T1 divided by T2A minus T1. So we calculate the T2A equal to T1 plus T2 minus T1 divided by efficiency of the compressor, which is 300 plus 543.4 minus 300 divided by 0.85. So efficiency of the compressor is 0.85. So calculating the actual temperature is 586.35 Kelvin. Then the isentropic expansion process, we calculate the T4, isentropic temperature, the outlet of the compressor expansion. So T4 equal to T3 into P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T3 into P1 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So we know P1 by P2 equal to 1 by RP pressure ratio. So this T3 into 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1100 into 1 divided by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 607.25 Kelvin. Then we define the turbine efficiency. Turbine efficiency is actual work divided by the isentropic work. So in terms of temperature, T3 minus T4A divided by T3 minus T4. So we calculate the T4A from this equation, rearranging T4A equal to T3 minus turbine efficiency into T3 minus T4. So 1100 minus 0.9 into 1100 minus 607.25 equal to 656.5 Kelvin. Now we refer the effectiveness of heat exchanger. So the definition, effectiveness of heat exchanger is actual enthalpy rise divided by the available enthalpy rise. So in terms of temperature, so T5 minus T2A divided by T4A minus T2A. That is the effectiveness of heat exchanger with reference to this diagram. So refer to this diagram, this is very important. So the amount of heat added to the air with the help of regeneration is T5 minus T2A. The amount of heat available at temperature difference, actual temperature difference of the regenerator is T4A, outlet temperature minus T2A. That is the maximum temperature difference in the heat exchanger. So from here we have to calculate T5. So temperature after regeneration. So T5 equal to T2A plus epsilon into T4A minus T2A, which is 586.35 plus 0.8 into 656.5 minus 586.35 equal to 642.47 Kelvin. Then the work output equal to turbine work output equal to Cp into T3 minus T4A. So 1.0032 into 1100 minus 656.5 equal to 444.92 kilojoules per kilogram. And compressor work input equal to Wc equal to Cp into T2A minus T1 equal to 1.0032 into 586.35 minus 300 equal to 287.3 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific work output, W equal to WT minus WC. So net work output are the specific work output, because the work produced is calculated in kilojoules per kilogram of air. That is why it is called a specific work output. So which is 444.92 minus 287.3 equal to 157.62 kilojoules per kilogram. So we have to calculate the work ratio. So remember this equation, work ratio, it is very important for competitive examination, because these are all the simple questions that will confuse you. Work ratio equal to net to work output divided by the turbine work. So WT minus WC is the net work output divided by the turbine work equal to 157.62 divided by 444.92 equal to 0.354. Then the heat supplied to the cycle, actually heat is supplied between T3 and T5. So Cp into T3 minus T5 equal to 1.0032 into 1100 minus 642.47 equal to 459 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the cycle efficiency. Now eta equal to W net divided by heat supplied equal to 157.62 divided by 459 into 100 equal to 34.34%. So the answer to the problem, cycle efficiency is 34.34%, work ratio is 0.354, and the specific work output equal to 157.62 kilojoules per kilogram. And we stop here. And these are all the books I referred for preparing this slide. You can also refer to it. I have written a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. There are other books available for further reading in this subject. So I conclude this lecture with a quote from Dr. Kalam. Dream is not which you see while sleeping. It is something that does not let you sleep. So you work hard and you will be a successful man in your life. And these are all the books I published. So Design of Transmission System, Turbo Emissions, Heat and Mass Transfer, Operations Research, Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, Thermal Engineering, Fluid Mechanics and Machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here. Also, the solution for the gate question paper is also uploaded. So, you can refer to it. Use the video lectures. You subscribe the channel. It is absolutely free of cost. You can use the video lectures for your better learning and to pass in the gate examination. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. So, you subscribe the channel and you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will sincerely answer. We'll meet again in the next video lecture with additional problems on the gas turbine cycle.